look first with me at the wisdom of heaven. What does she do? She mobilizes the people of God to gather together and to pray. Let me just remind you of that. Go gather all the Jews to be found in Susa. That meant gather them to their synagogue. Gather them and hold a fast on my behalf, and don't eat or drink for 3 days, night or day. I and my young women will also fast as you do. What she was asking them was not just a fast, but to fast and pray. That's what she was really asking. We who know the Hebrew scriptures can add that. Some looking on, all they would see was the fasting and think, oh, the girls in the harem are going on a diet. Esther's on a diet, one of her diets, yet again. But no, it was deliberate. It was purposeful. She was fasting and praying. And she prays herself, you notice, there in verse 16 of chapter 4. She prays herself, she and the young women who by now know she is a Jewess. By now she has gathered them around her. They share her common faith. She's not been inactive. She has been working and witnessing and living out her life and has influenced people. And there they are with her, and they're sharing with her in the business of prayer. Why does she pray? Why does she cast herself on God? It was because she knew, in the language of our catechism and our confession, she knew that all things come to pass immutably and infallibly by the providence of God. But she also knew that God orders these things to happen, sometimes according to the nature of second causes. One of those second causes is the prayer of God's people that he uses in order to accomplish his will in the world.